Do you think that OPEC needs to act and act soon to put a floor under the oil price?
Yeah, I think first of all, it's good to be with you. And we just had the joint ministerial monitoring committee meeting. And I think we have said that we need to change strategy. Obviously, 2019 is going to have its own challenges. And we are ready in our next meeting to change strategy and adopt whatever needed to maintain the balance on the supply and demand. We closely monitor the inventories. Those are the fundamentals, and we are intended to keep the inventories at the level where they are, with avoiding the risk of the buildup, but at the same time avoiding the risk of a major drawdown from the inventories, to keep both consumers as well as producers at a point of balance in terms of bringing investments, but at the same time enabling the economy, the world economy, to grow and prosper.
Can I ask, Mr. Almaturi, how much does the increase in production in the U.S. With their shale resources there, and the unexpectedly high amount of waivers given out for the Iranian sanctions, increase other oil demand that you weren't expecting, or other oil supply that you weren't expecting? I mean, how much does that play into the equation?
I think it does play a significant role into the equation, and whenever we look at our production and adjusting our production as OPEC and non-OPEC members, is to balance whatever it comes from those producers outside the group. And you're right, most of the expectation were exceeded when it comes to the production from the United States and from other producers as well. That's why we need always to monitor all of those factors and adjust as needed to the market balance. We have cut in the past and to reach the market balance, and if we need to cut production to adjust to keep the market balance, we will do. But we will not overdo it. We are always going to keep that balance, and our reference is going to be the 5 years average that we worked very hard for a year and a half with our non-OPEC members to achieve. So I think if it comes to the question, are we going to act and act fast? I think we have in early December the meeting, and I'm expecting that those group of responsible producers will reach consensus and take the right measures to keep the market at balance.
So, Minister, December's still a way off, of course, but your best guess as to how much needs to be cut then in December?
Well, when we met at the JMMC, we asked the technical team to go and look at recommendations on the required adjustment. And as you can see, October has been a very fluctuating month. And we are moving now in November, and we are seeing that fluctuation. But there are things outside our control, which are the speculations in the market. The market fundamentals are still reasonable, not to justify the drop that we had yesterday. But at the same time, we are dealing with so many other factors. I think when we're talking about the level, we will need to monitor, as your colleague mentioned, how much is coming from the non-OPEC and adjust when we meet. I think the exact number will be studied by the technical group, and they will bring that to the ministers' meeting in December. I think my expectation that adjustment and the group will reach consensus on whatever required to adjust the market. I cannot throw in a number prematurely, but whatever that required number, I have a confidence that the group that have worked very hard to achieve what they have achieved, they will not just let go of it in 2019.
Where do you think, Mr. Minister, you know, assuming you make those cuts, and we've heard numbers, for example, from Secretary General Barkindo and others that they should be around a million barrels, cuts of a million barrels a month for OPEC and friends next month. Where do you think that the right supply energy equation would put the oil price? I mean, what feels right to you for a price on Brent crude next month?
I think when it comes to what feels right, is a price is a result. It's not a target for us. We're not targeting a certain price. We're targeting a balance in the inventories. And the inventories, I think, is a fair area of focus for us to look at. So the average 5 years would be a good reference to try to maintain. You cannot pin it to the last barrel, but we will try to keep it at the right level that we had in the past. I would say 3 to 4 months when we reached that 5 years average. The price of oil is not a target, and we cannot target a price. We concern and we hear the consumers. Whether they are from the United States, whether they are from China, from India, and OPEC have transformed significantly in hearing those voices. And in June when we met, and there was a requirement or a fear that available production is not enough, we made sure that to bring that production. And in December when we meet, if there is a requirement to curtail, whatever the required curtail, the required cut, we will cut in according to what we agree on. Whatever price that end up with, that's not the market will decide the price, but not us as a group. We are targeting what is good for consumers to keep the economy growing, and at the same time enable us to do the investments, and they require attract investors to continue investing in this important commodity. So that is, okay. I think, the balance, and the market will decide what is that price.